And remember, with a little rust ease and an insane amount of luck, you two can look like me. Ka-chow.
My daughter and I crocheted a blanket together using this yarn. She chose this super cute colorway, and with one cake, you can actually knit or crochet a blanket with these dimensions. The patterns are inside the label. We actually wanted a bigger blanket, so we used a 12 millimeter hook and only single crochet stitches. We took turns and used two cakes to crochet this beautiful blanket together.
All right, progress update on the campfire blanket. I finished making the base part, and I've been weaving in the chains for this brown color. I feel so validated in choosing to remake this entire blanket as opposed to just using my notes from previous makes. This is the largest version of the blanket I've ever made, and the thing is, the chains are always a little bit bigger than the actual blanket. But the thing is, you don't know how much, you kinda have to dial it in. So I figured out how long the chains need to be, and now comes the fun part of weaving them in. This part isn't hard, but it can be tedious. Especially if you don't sew cleanly around the stitches and then it winds up going through the ply and then it gets stuck and boy, that's just no fun. So yeah, this is one side, just the brown color, and now I'm going to start on the gray color chains that are going to go in between. It really helps give the blanket a great texture. And then in case you thought this blanket was going to be done, oh no, we're going to have to do the other end of the blanket. But honestly, it's so worth it. It looks great. I had some super exciting news. I have finished the actual campfire blanket. Please celebrate with me. I am immensely excited. I have made this blanket 3 times previously, but this is the biggest and honestly best rendition of it. I've made a lot of progress in writing up the pattern and prepping the Etsy listing, but this week is really hard for me. I'm a little bit delayed on the YouTube video support, but please celebrate with me. Look how beautiful this is. And thank you for all your support.
This is day 10 of TikTok Keep Me Accountable because I need to finish these bridesmaids blankets so I can ask my bridesmaids to be in my wedding. So we are almost done with this blue blanket. Here is the before. All we have is our 30 rows of gray, 10 rows of white, and then we are done with our second blanket. So I will see you when the 30 rows is done. I am happy to report we have finished the 30 rows of gray. We are on the last section of this blanket. We have 10 rows of white, and then it's completely done. I'm so excited. I'll see you guys on TikTok Live to finish it.
Thank you.
finally finished my 2020 temperature blanket. The colors are adorable and fun. I absolutely love how it turned out. I decided to crochet my Nana blanket. She has low vision, so I made it as bright as possible.
To wrap things up, quite literally, I used the final color, which symbolizes my mom, to wrap the entire blanket as a border. When I think of my mom, I think of sunny days with wispy clouds and bright yellow sun. Convertible top-down, hair in the wind kind of feel. Altogether, it took me 70 hours to make, and there we have it. Hold on, I think I left something under here. Kit? Oh, not Kit. Hi, Mom. Thanks for watching.
Check out how to make this big, bulky corner-to-corner blanket. This pattern is free on my blog with a full video on YouTube. So start out by chaining 6. Then work back, a double crochet in the 4th chain from the hook and in the next 2 chains. This completes your first block. Now chain 6 to increase. Work a double crochet in the 4th chain from the hook and in the next 2 chains. The corner to corner blankets worked on the diagonal. Now slip stitch in the chain space, you'll chain 3 and then work 3 double crochets all in that same space. You can go check out the full tutorial on my YouTube channel. Follow me for more tips and crochet tutorials.
It just dawned on me that I haven't shown you guys my temperature blanket since possibly March. So I want to show you it all updated. I have 2 new colors added, and then I'm going to show you my favorite little bit. So this is it kind of wonkily laid on my couch. I'm trying to stand back enough that it fits in. This is my favorite bit, and I don't know why. I just think this green, orange, and red really go together quite nice. And it's the warmest day of the year, and I remember it because I had the day off. So what do you think?
Alright guys, it's another temperature blanket update. Where I live in Montana, it may be calling for snow, but in here, it's summertime. I'm in mid-July and we're hitting a lot of oranges and reds and just a little bit of yellow. I'm hoping by Halloween to be mid-August.
Remember the blanket I was making? I finished it yesterday. I love it. I think it took me approx 8 hours. Do you like it?
Good morning! You guys helped me pick out these 3 yarn colors and I just wanted to show you what I ended up doing with them. So this was my inspiration. It's wallpaper from Wayfair. And the first thing I thought of when I saw it is how easy it would be to do 4 separate panels and corner to corner crochet and put it all together. So let me show you how it turned out. So here's the finished piece. I love how it turned out. This side is the seamless side where I have joined them together. There's no like visible seam for it. And then the other side has these lines going down. It's just a row of single crochet, which I think still is super cute too. I don't know, what do you guys think? Which side's your favorite? Seamless or the single crochet side? Let me know. And here's just a couple pics that I got the other day. I'm kind of obsessed with how it turned out. And Charlie modeled for me too. Isn't she so cute?
Hi there. So I've been crocheting a blanket and I call it my stress blanket because I crochet every time I'm stressed. And it's getting big. I'm really stressed.
I just finished week 27 of my temperature blanket. For this blanket, I am crocheting one row for each day of the year and using the average temperature of that day and this color chart to figure out which color to crochet with. The blanket got to travel with me once again while I visited my family. Back in Iowa, we got some heat and the average temps got up to 80 in the first half of this week. In the second half of this week, the temperatures cooled down enough to get some more yellow back into the blanket and to break up our huge chunk of orange. And this is what the blanket looks like so far. See you next week with another update.
Watch this, y'all. It's my hidden talent. Oh, you want me to do it again?
This was one of my first projects, and I think it might be one of the largest projects I've ever made. This was a blanket for my husband, who is 6'1". He needed a nice and comfy blanket to curl up on the couch with. Now for perspective, I'm 5'9". This thing is huge. Like all things, it was made with love, and it was definitely appreciated by him, but I don't know if he appreciates it quite enough. So do me a favor, stitch this and show me the biggest project you've ever made. Because this one's huge.
Let's make this bulky striped blanket. You're going to need 21 balls of bulky weight yarn and a 9mm crochet hook. It's a fun cluster stitch pattern that's really quick and easy to make. It's just a one row repeat throughout the blanket. You're just going to be changing up colors to get a fun striped pattern. You can get this pattern for free on my blog and I have a full tutorial on YouTube. Follow me for more crochet tutorials and tips.